All right, now it's time to install the software. So you're gonna get your software that comes in your package. This is vCarve Desktop 8.0. You're gonna wanna get 8.5, that's what's out right now. And you're gonna wanna install this with your clip art. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to go through the tutorials and everything. So just a little bit about that. Over here on the left, we've got the tutorial browser. So if you click on that, you're gonna see all the tutorials. There's about 50 to 70 videos on pretty much anything you wanna design to get you started. And that way you can learn the software. We're gonna go ahead and create a new file here. I'll show you how to set one up real quick. Our piece of wood that we're gonna be engraving on is 7 inches by 7, or approximately. I'm gonna put 7 by 7 up here. The thickness of the wood is 3/4 of an inch. And basically the positioning on the board, this needs to match how you mark the board onto on your Piranha physically. So I'm centering everything right here. So I'm gonna register that. I'm gonna show you how to do that on the particular hardware that you're using. So we're gonna basically set this to 0 right here, or in the middle, I'm sorry. And then we're gonna say okay. Now, I'm not gonna show you all the stuff in here, but if we were just gonna try to type in some text, all we have to do is come over here and there's a little T. It's almost like Microsoft Word. You're gonna click on that. A little dialog box comes up and we're gonna type in test. And then, these are TrueType fonts. So any font that you have on your computer, it's gonna pull into here. So I can come up here and I can change the font to something else that I might want, but it has to be on the computer. If not, just pull it from another computer. So we're gonna pick Garamond. You can bold it. And then also we're gonna center it. And this tells you what size the text is. If you don't know what size it's gonna be, it doesn't matter, because you can keep changing it as you go. So basically we're gonna hit apply, and there it is on the screen. Now again, if it's not the right size, just go in here and change it. This is in inches. We're gonna put 0.75. Hit apply, and now it's bigger. If you just wanna grab it and make it larger, you can do that too. It's either way, and all you gotta do is hit apply, that'll do it. There's also, you can do things precisely with the anchor and a drawing position if you want, and that's fine too. So we're just gonna say close. Let's make it a little bigger. We'll do it 1 inch. And it assumes I'm using inches because I haven't changed anything, any of the settings on it. So it's gonna use inches. Now, it's not in the center, which that's fine if we want it to render there, but there's a real easy icon that says align selection, selected object. So it's already selected because it's pink here. So we'll click on that. Come up here and hit align material, and that's gonna align it to everything and not just to center or outside edge inside. And then we hit close and now it's centered. Now there's other ways to move it. Real simple, you just click on it a second time and now you can see this box like you would in any program. And you can grab it if you want. If it's not the right place, just control Z will move it back to where you want. You can also do it up here, undo or redo. So it's got a lot of the same things that Microsoft Word would have, but it's a really powerful package. Anyway, we're gonna do the word test. And now what we have to do is we have to choose what tool path we wanna use for this, okay? So we can click off here. And then now it's still selected as well, but we'll go to the tool path because we need to carve this out. So I'm gonna lock this over here. Here's some more icons, but basically these are your toolpath operations. This would be one for profiling to cut something out, or you can pocket something or drill, you know, drill things, create inlays. But we're just gonna pick the simple V-carve one. And then also, I'm going to tell it that I want to select the right tool now. I've got a couple of bits here. This one, this particular one that we're gonna use today is a V bit with a 45 degree, but it's actually a 3/32 and a 45 degree at the end. I'll show you that whenever we use the hardware. So I'm gonna click on that. The parameters are already in there unless you create a new, a copy of it or the bit. You wanna change the speeds or anything like that. You don't have to worry about the spindle speed. This is something where you're gonna set this on your router, whether yours is variable or not. You're just gonna turn it on or set it to 5 or 6, which would be in the 16,000 range. The feed rate, basically that's how many inches per minute this thing can run. If you set it on too fast, it might kind of botch up your carving a little bit because it'll be too fast. Generally 70 to 100 is good. And then there's a plunge rate, and that's how it plunges down into the wood. 30 is fine. We're just gonna say okay. And there's not really much to test on the carving. You don't have to set a lot of parameters. That's basically it. You can do flat spots if you want it to go all the way down, but we're not gonna really get into that right now. We're just gonna show you how to do something kind of quick and easy. So we're gonna just leave these like they are, and then we'll go down to the bottom here, and this is where we name it. So we're just gonna say V-carve 1 and calculate it. Calculating it shows you, basically all I did is grab this too with my mouse, and what these lines are is it tells you where the bit's gonna move around to carve this out. Okay, so we're actually, I can rotate it, zoom in and out by rotating the little thumb control on my mouse. You will want to use a mouse during this. It's hard with just a laptop with no mouse. So, okay, so we're going to do this. We're going to go ahead and actually see what it looks like. This is the preview tool. We're going to preview all tool paths, even though we only have one. We'll just click on that. And it shows you basically what it's going to look like, kind of how deep it's going to go, but it gives you a rendering of it. That way you know before you go cutting anything, does it look right? Did something jump off the page? I know we only have one thing on here, but if you have more, you want to make sure it doesn't jump off. And that's the wire drawing of it, or line art, and that's the 3D of it. Okay, so not real big, it's not a big test, but, and we'll close that. And now just get down to the nitty gritty. We're going to save the tool path. So all we got to do is select it. And now the tool path is selected and it knows which one we want to save. So we're going to save the tool path and we just click on that. We've already got CNC Piranha 3D over here selected. So we're good to go. Yours should already say that if you've bought a CNC Piranha anyway. Now, if we had more paths over here, it would actually line them all up. It'd gang them all up with one bit. Each bit, it'll actually gang those up. If you have to change the bit out to a different bit, you're gonna have to actually save another path. So anyway, we're gonna do that. We're gonna say save tool path, and I'm gonna save mine. I go to Piranha, and I actually separate mine. My carve files should be in one folder, and my tap files in the other, which that's what it's called. The G-code creates a tap. This is basically a tap file that you're gonna be using for your Piranha machine. So we're gonna click on that. I'm gonna say test, take pen test, and save it. Now once I've done that, I'm gonna actually take my thumb drive here. So we'll take that out. I'm gonna pop this in. Actually, I'll pop it in over here. All right, that tells me I've got the drive in. Now I'm gonna go ahead, and it's better if I've run into some problems where you just try to save it to the USB thumb drive. It keeps thinking it's in use. So the easiest way to do that is to not mess around with it. And then come over here. I'll click to my folders. I'm gonna go back to my CNC Piranha file. So we'll just start over again, Piranha files, tap file. I'm gonna go down to my test right here and I'm going to copy that and then go to my Lexar Media, which is the my little thumb drive, and I'm gonna paste it in there. And you do need to paste it to the root drive, so don't make a folder, and because the hardware can't really find it. You'll see on the controller when I show you that. So anyway, now we're set. I'll close that and I'll dismount this, eject that, and that's it. Now, if you do want to save the file, you can basically save it. Just go under File, Save, and then we can save that back into our standard carving files and then put that in here. And then you can come back to it later and recreate a path if you need to or whatever. So that's it for that part of it. Now we're going to go to the hardware. Okay, the first thing we want to do when we get our Piranha after we unbox it, there's going to be a controller or a pendant that needs a controller ID and everything. So you're going to go to the NextWave site, and then you're going to go to register, and then you need to basically type in all this stuff. And when we turn on the machine outside, I'll show you that when this first comes up, your pendant is gonna not allow you to go any further but to register the product. So once you register it, it tells you that you need to you know, apply these numbers into the pendant to gain access to the actual hardware. So it'll make sense once I show you. But anyway, you're gonna fill all this out. And then once you send this, it has your email address and everything, okay? And who you purchased it from. Within 5 minutes, you're gonna get the ID so that you can plug in these numbers into the controller or the pendant. And then it will unlock it for you. So that's about it for that part. So we'll go to the next part. All right, so we're out here with the hardware, which is the actual Piranha machine. In this particular one, I got a Colt router, the Boss Colt. For this model, so if you have the Colt router and you buy the Piranha, you need to buy this little adapter right here to fit that. Okay, it says Bosch on it. If you have, and that's an extra cost. Okay, so if you have a DeWalt router or a Porter cable, it already comes with this mount and you're ready to go. But otherwise, what you're going to do is take your router and mount it into the mount here, which mounts to the actual machine. Okay. Now, as far as hooking this up, it's pretty easy. Out of the box, everything's already just as you see it. So you've got these pieces. I can just show you a little bit of how it's made. It's thick plastic. This stuff is, right here would be thick plastic. And then you've got your servos, one, two, and then there's another one in the back, right back there, that controls the XYZ axis. So each one has a cable that comes down to the main power supply and controller for it. So it's very easy. We got XYZ, and we actually have that labeled in the center there, how to hook them up. You can't pretty much hook them up wrong if you look at, you know, look at the symbols there. Otherwise, that's all you do for the servos. And then we've got the pendant here that I was telling you about that you have to register. And that hooks into this particular one right here. And then we've got our power supply that hooks into this one and our on-off switch. Now, if you buy different things, like there's an accessory module like the laser, then that's when you're going to be using these guys right here, okay? It comes with a clamp down, two of them. Okay, now, One thing you're going to want to do is when you first start out is you need to learn that you got to put pieces of wood on there straight, obviously, or else it's going to carve something crooked on there, and then you're going to have to cut the piece later afterwards. Now, in the video of the software, I noted that you need to set up your software and tell it where you want to register this on your hardware. That's the center point. So we're telling it, hey, when I go ahead and register the bit down to the wood, I'm basically telling it that's the starting point and that's the reference point between the hardware and the software. Okay? So now what we're going to do is we're going to click this, click the power supply on, and it just makes a sound. Sometimes you'll hear a little noise from one of the servos, and that's normal. But we'll come down to the pendant. Now at this point, you've already entered the code that you received in an email after you registered the pendant. Okay, so all we have to do is hit okay, okay, and now we get to this. And this is what it looks like. I always change the fast to slow, and that's basically how this actually jogs back and forth, up and back, up and down. So we're gonna go ahead and change that from to slow, and then hit update, and that updates it. And now, when we go ahead and hit right, left, away, that kind of stuff, it actually moves this unit, okay? So I'm actually gonna see if I can hold the camera and put the bit that we have, which is, I hope you can see that, it's not too sharp. That bit right there, I'm actually gonna try to put it down right onto that point. And it's not hard if you're not holding the camera, so let's try this. I'm gonna go ahead and move it near. And you just kind of get it close and then start moving it down. That'll get you a little bit closer. Then I'm going to kind of move back and forth to try to get it registered. Like I said, it's not that hard if you are not holding the camera. So anyway, we're just going to kind of do that. You can kind of see how it's moving. It's a little bit too far. You need to have access to pretty much all directions, why, you know, as far as being able to see. Let's see, we're gonna do that way. So let me get this set real quick. And you're gonna need a piece of paper so that you can reference that. So let me get that, hold on. Okay, so now I've got my piece of paper. It's just a regular little pad, piece of paper that I tore off. And then what we're gonna do is keep tapping the down until it touches it or drags on it. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get in a good shot of that. And we're almost there. See how it can move a little, but it's still dragging on it. And we're gonna hit down. And now it's touching it. So see how it's pulling on it? Okay, now what we can do is we can come back down to our pendant, and we need to zero this. So we're gonna zero it by just clicking on zero, and it's gonna ask us. These are all the movements I made since I turned it on. And then we're gonna say okay. And now it's set to the zero spot, okay? That's actually the height of the wood and actually where the reference point is in the very center of the wood. So I'm gonna go ahead and move the controller up. Okay, and then we're gonna stop. I'm gonna pull this back out. And I'm gonna show you, basically, if we wanna go home to that home position, okay, especially if we change the bit or whatever. Let's go ahead, I'm gonna hit the home button over here, but then I'm gonna pan over to the actual bit and show you how it moves back into its place. So we're gonna go ahead and do this. And it stops exactly where I put it, okay? Now what I'm gonna do is come back down here, I'm gonna lift it up. Now, one good thing to do when you're new is, and you haven't carved anything, is you're gonna wanna air carve it, which means you're not gonna turn the router on. You're gonna reset the zero point, okay, while the machine and the bit is up high. That way you can see if it goes off track or not, okay? I'm not gonna do that right now because I'm gonna actually just carve it. I've done it a bunch of times now. I've got to demo this quite a bit, so. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead, turn on the router, and then I'm gonna plug in my USB thumb drive, so I'll show you how to do that. And then we're gonna load that file, that test file in. I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that, okay? So here we go. All right, so those of you that don't have one yet, the USB thumb drive goes into the right side over here. I'm gonna stick that in. Actually, it goes upside down. Okay, so now it's sticking into the side there. And you couldn't see it before, but this USB was actually gray, because there wasn't anything plugged into it. Once I plugged it in, it turns blue. I click on it, and now I've got my files. I've got a whole bunch of files here, but you see test tap file? We're gonna click on that. And now you can see test up here in the very top. And these are all the XYZ coordinates that we set in the program, okay? Vectrix software, it tells you the file, when I made it, everything. Then we're gonna say load. And now we're ready to go. Now I'm going to tell you this. If you start carving and you hit the e-stop button, it loses its place. You can't restart somewhere. The only way you can do this is if you hit pause. So don't stop the carving unless there's a problem. Just let it go ahead and finish. So anyway, it's going to tell you how many lines it sent, and it's going to give us a percentage of completion and everything. So let me go ahead. Turn the router on. Goes back to the home position. Now you can see how far away I have my controller and my pendant, and you can see just that little bit got it dirty. So that's why you don't want your computer out here. So anyway, we've got that done, and it tells you right there it took 57 seconds to do it. It ignored one line, not sure what was with that, but anyway, 100% complete, and it's done. I'm going to go ahead and basically, you're going to want to click out of here. I'm just going backwards so I can actually lift my bit up so I can show you a better drawing of it. Now, you can see I hit a knot there, but otherwise this thing would look really good. That does have a V-carving bit in it. Now, as far as the size of material you can use, it's about 11 inches from left to right in a portrait mode, but you can go lengthwise as far as you want, but you will have to tile the software, and that's something that you'll have to learn in the with the tutorials. It's not that hard, and it sounds like, whoa, how would you do that? But it's not too hard. They have good videos on that. So anyway, hope this helped you. If you wanted to start learning about the Piranha CNC, I'm lucky I got a chance to demo this unit. It's $15.99. Sometimes there's sales on it. But it's a great, it's a great little carver. And like I said, you can buy the laser attachment, and there's also a 3D attachment, to create 3D objects. So, I don't know about that. I don't have that much experience with that, but I do know that it's a very good carver, and it's never messed up yet. I've carved, 50 or so objects already with it, and no problems whatsoever, no glitches. But Next Wave is really good. They are very, they respond really well if you text, email them, or call them. As far as the VCarve software, I haven't had any issues with that. I've never talked to them yet. But anyway, very good unit. Hope you liked the video.